Hi, welcome back to Daybreak. This is Dave. He's from Amazing Hazels. He's here telling me all about this very special sauce to you and now to all of Indiana, because this is homemade right here in our neck of the woods. You're on the northwest side of Indianapolis. Tell me the history of this sauce.
How did this come to be? This is my grandmother's recipe that I rediscovered after my mother passed away. My mom died in 2014. I found the recipe in some of her stuff that was hidden away, and I started making it for family and friends. I remember eating it as a child on scrambled eggs and different ways to eat sauces. When I started making it, my friends said, you have really got to start making this commercially. So
you took their advice and ran with it.
I took the dive, and here we are.
How would you describe your sauce? It says gourmet chili sauce and zesty.
It is a gourmet chili sauce, zesty. Mm-hmm. It starts off sweet, and about 12 or 15 seconds later has a little kick.
Kicks you.
It's not overpowering, but it's very, very tasty. It's great on scrambled eggs, burgers, baked potatoes, and a salad. I've made Sloppy Joe sliders today.
I love it.
As well as some that you can dip with chips.
Sounds like a really versatile sauce.
It
you can
is.
Use it in a lot
it
of
really
ways.
Is.
I love local success stories like this that are Indiana grown. A lot of us like to support Indiana products. Where can we find your sauce?
Right now, I am at Georgetown Market on the northwest side. I'm in the Real Food Shop in Plainfield.
Okay.
In addition to that, I'm 12 or 14 Fresh Thyme markets. Market District in Carmel, several other places as well.
Great for you. Okay.
People taste it, they try it, they love it, so they ask for it.
All right, so let's put it to use for maybe your menu tomorrow when you're watching football, Sloppy Joe's.
Sloppy Joe's. And what I do here in this Sloppy Joe recipe, I have a pound of ground beef and one can of red gold tomato paste. And then I add, as you can see, an exact measurement, about 12 ounces of my sauce. And let this cook down, and it'll cook like this on low heat after the ground beef has already been drained and browned.
That's pretty quick.
Yeah,
you know, just
it'll cook down.
Simple.
And once that's done, then I have already in the pot for
what
you
we have
to,
over here?
To try.
Oh, that's a finished product.
That's the finished product over there.
Fantastic. And I can just build a Sloppy Joe slider.
You can build a Sloppy Joe slider.
Okay.
There should be a spoon right there.
I see it. This is great, Dave, because you know what it was your family's recipe can now be the secret ingredient at you know my party or anybody else's party.
And there's dill relish, banana peppers.
What would you recommend?
I'd like to have a little dill relish and a little shredded cheese. But
is that this? You know, this is the dill.
That's the dill.
Okay. All right. I love it. It's nice to have a little. It's like a build your own.
Absolutely.
Sloppy Joe bar. I've never thought of doing that, so that's a good idea for tomorrow as well. All right. You see this, Marcus? Who's jealous?
Dig in.
I'm going to do so off camera because I'm afraid it is sloppy and it might get on my dress. I still have some more Daybreak to go here, Dave.
So
thank you so much for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
And look for Amazing Hazels in all of the locations that you mentioned.
Yes.
And we wish you continued success.
Thank you
thanks
so
for helping
much.
Us out with our
it.
Football Sunday menu. Marcus?
I appreciate it.
All right. I'll talk so you can go ahead and dive into this.